Hello and welcome to today's tutorial on mastering security auditing with Lynis. So here we can see we're on the Lynis homepage, which includes the documentation. You just go ahead and in your favorite browser search, in your favorite search engine in your browser, search for Lynis and you'll see it comes up at CISO. FI produces the software. So in this tutorial, you'll learn how to use Lynis. It's a powerful open source security auditing tool to analyze and improve the security of your Linux system. This guide is perfect for beginners and intermediate Linux users who want to identify and fix vulnerabilities, misconfigurations, and compliance issues in their system. Let's dive in. So as we've said, Lynis is widely used and it's open source and it's a security auditing tool designed for all Unix-based operating systems. If you take a look in the documentation, it'll show you that it's available for absolutely all Unix-based operating systems, including FreeBSD, etc. And it can even run on Raspberry Pi and IoT devices. I'm going to be installing and using Lynis on Ubuntu, and whether you're using personal, server, or cloud purposes, Lynis can significantly enhance the security of your Linux system. Let's get started. So I can just open up my terminal. Where I'd like to be is I'd like to be in my home directory, cd tilde, in the home directory. I can go ahead and clear up. The first thing that I want to do is I want to update and upgrade my system. So I want to update my actual operating system and I want to upgrade all installed packages and software before I continue. So I can just do a sudo apt. Remember, if you're using another distribution, it could be yum or something else. Sudo apt update. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to update my operating system. Now that my OS has been updated, let's go ahead and upgrade all installed packages and tools so I can hit sudo apt upgrade. Hit enter. It's going to upgrade all installed packages. Now that everything's been done, we can go ahead and we can install and use Lynis. Simply sudo apt install Lynis or using whatever package manager depending on your distribution. And it's going to go ahead and install Lynis. Now that Lynis has been successfully installed, we can go ahead and check the installation. And you're just going to type in Lynis dash dash version anywhere in a terminal. And it's going to bring up that 3.0.9 has been installed. Let's go ahead and clear our screens. So let's go ahead and run a basic audit. So simply from the command line, we can type in sudo, call Lynis, and we go ahead and audit and system and hit enter. And our audit will be performed. So we can see that it's carrying on and it's going ahead and it's performing the audit. You can follow along with the audit and it's showing exactly what it's auditing. So it's started off by detecting exactly our OS. It's detected Ubuntu, the version and the hardware platform. So it's x86, x64. It's my virtual machine that's running. And it's going to go ahead and it's going to run through its audit. So it's going to begin at system tools, plugins, Debian tests. Carrying on with Debian tests, we can see if we follow along that it's going to give us updates, warnings, and other information that'll be in square brackets. It'll either be in green, red for warnings, and also yellow for suggestions. So during this audit, Lynis will check various aspects of the system, including kernel configuration, installed packages and their versions, file system permissions, user accounts and security settings, and secure shell configurations, and much, much more. Let's let it go ahead and run till the end. Now, the Lynis security audit has been completed. Now, if I just scroll up and I take a look, I can go ahead into the entire history and I can just scroll through and I can look one by one under the various headings, for example, security frameworks, etc. And I can go ahead and I can interpret my results. If I come all the way to the end of the scan, it's given us a summary of the scan details now. It's given us something called a hardening index. What the hardening index is Lynis assigns this hardening index to your system, and it's a quick overview of your system's overall security posture. It's calculated up to a score of 100, and a score closer to 100 is better. Even a score in the 80s can indicate a solid security baseline. We see that my system has scored a 63, which means that it needs work. Checking specific components, it's checked for firewall, which actually is installed. And I don't have a malware scanner installed in the system. We can see a big red X. And scan mode is normal for forensics integration or pen test. Lynis modules, comply status, it's given me a question mark there. Security audit, it's given me the V for normal, vulnerability scan is normal, and it's given us a couple of files. So there's test and debug information, which you can find the entire log for the scan, which is under var log Lynis log, and there's also report data, which is under Lynis report.dat. Now, if I scroll a little bit up here, just at the end of the scan, it's going to give me the results in a more readable format, which I can go through better. So we have warnings. Warnings indicate critical security issues, such as outdated packages or weak configurations. For example, if you see a warning about an outdated package, it's a high priority issue. So it's telling me that IP tables is loaded, but no rules are active. So this is something that I have to actively reconfigure. It's giving me a whole bunch of suggestions, given 40. You can go through the suggestions. For example, this release is more than 4 months old. Check the website to GitHub to see if there's an update available, etc., etc. So that's for Lynis itself. And you can go ahead and you can run through this as you wish, and you can take a look and you can go ahead and you can work on any one of the suggestions. It's also given follow-up, so it can show details of a test. Check the log file for all details. Read security control text here at cisofire.com. And use, you can upload data to the central system, which is for Lynis Enterprise users. Now, since we've got the log files, let's go ahead and take a look at the log files. So I'm just going to change directory to var log. So if I just do change directory, /log, I'm in var log. If I ls, we can see that we have Lynis log and we've got Lynis report. So if I just go ahead and clear my screen so you can see what's going on, I can use my favorite text or code editor and I can just sudo nano and I do lynis.log. And now I'm in the Lynis log for the complete audit. And if you'd like, you can go through this entire log. You can also output this into a text file and use it somewhere else. I'm just going to control X to exit. If I want to take a look at the Lynis report, I can do the same thing using nano. And the entire report is open up here and it gives a whole breakdown from the OS and through the rest of the audit. I don't want to change anything. I can just X out and clear my screen. So I've been through in previous videos in detail firewalls, including UFW firewall and also hardening SSH and so on. I'm not going to go into these topics in this video. You can go ahead and you can look at my other videos for this information. But what I will do for you here is show you how to automate this. So you can automate regular security audits, and we can do this using a cron job in Linux, which is our scheduled tasks in Linux. And what you can do is you can just from anywhere. So I'm actually going to change the directory back to my home. Go ahead and clear my screen. And from here, I can just go ahead and do sudo crontab and give it the E. And it's opened up in nano. I've already configured crontab to be opened up in nano. You can configure it into whatever you like to use. So it tells you here, edit this file to introduce tasks to be run by cron. So this is where all our cron jobs are. So for the automated Lynis audit, I'm going to hit 02 ***. And then we're going to go ahead and usr bin Lynis audit system. This will be run. Put my redirector operator and it's going to find it at var log Lynis underscore daily run daily dot log. Now I can hit control 0 in nano, control O rather, to go ahead and save that, and control X to X out. Let me go ahead and clear my screen. So let's recap what we've learned today. We've installed Lynis on an Ubuntu system. We've run a basic audit and we've reviewed the results. Shown how to take action on warnings and suggestions to enhance security. And we've also shown you how to automate regular scans to maintain a secure system. Make sure to run Lynis regularly to stay on top of your system security. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, IT Pro Today, for more Linux security tutorials. Stay safe out there. Bye for now.